This hour is yours, the Standard Hour. This evening from Seattle, Washington, the Standard Oil Company of California presents the second in a new series of Standard Hour programs featuring the music of famous operas being seen and heard during the current opera season on the Pacific Coast. Gaetano Merola, General Director of the San Francisco Opera Company, conducts the San Francisco Opera Orchestra for this series, in which singing stars of the Metropolitan and San Francisco Opera Companies are being presented as featured soloists. Tonight we shall hear Licia Albanese, Maria Saer, John Pierce, and Francesco Valentino in a condensation of Giacomo Puccini's famous 19th century musical picture of Bohemian life in the Latin Quarter of Paris, La Bohème. There is no overture to this opera. The music starts as the curtain rises to disclose the interior of an artist's studio. Here four young men live and work: Marcel, Colline, Schaunard, and Rudolph. Rudolph is alone in the studio writing. The quietude of the studio is broken by a timid knock at the door. Rudolph opens it. A pale young girl stands on the threshold. Rudolph is struck by her frail beauty and notices that she seems faint and exhausted. He asks her in. She explains that her candle has blown out as she ascended the stairs to her room, and she asks if Rudolph will light it for her. He does so, but as he opens the door for her to leave, the draft again blows it out, and she drops her key. Rudolph purposely blows out his own candle and pretends to help her hunt for the key in the darkness. His hand seeks hers, and as he clasps it tenderly, he prevents her leaving by telling her who he is and something of his life as a writer. Thank you. Rudolph then asks the young girl, "Who are you?" She answers demurely, "They call me Mimi. In my room up above you, I live alone. For a living, I embroider flowers on fine satins and silks. Up in my little garret so high, the first sunlight greets me. There, spring's first sweet fragrance is mine. The flowers I fashion, alas, have no perfume." Rudolph opens the window of the studio, and moonlight floods the room. He turns and is enchanted by his vision of Mimi. "Lovely maid in the moonlight," he whispers. "Say you love me." Softly, as they walk arm in arm out into the night, she confesses, "I love you." Later, Rudolph and Mimi wait outside a cafe for his friends to celebrate Christmas Eve. Mimi wears a new bonnet, which Rudolph has just brought her as a Christmas gift. Marcel, Colleen, and Shonar arrive, and they enter the cafe. Marcel catches sight of his faithless sweetheart, Musetta, with an elderly escort. Jealous, Marcel pretends not to notice her. Musetta sings a waltz song to attract his attention. Marcel is again swayed by her irresistible charm. Musetta gets rid of her escort by sending him away on an errand, and she joins Marcel's party. A military patrol comes by, and they all march out of the cafe in high spirits, leaving the bill for the old man to pay on his return.
Thank you.
So ends the first half of Puccini's La Boheme. The Standard Hour will bring you the second half in just a few moments. We pause briefly for station identification. You are listening to the Standard Hour, brought to you by the Standard Oil Company of California. Before continuing with our program, the Standard Oil Company of California would like to ask you a question. What kind of music do you prefer to hear on the Standard Hour? It is sometimes difficult for those in charge of the Standard Hour to forecast your musical preferences. In fact, it has been decided that the only way to determine what you want to hear is by asking you. As a result, we have now prepared a simple questionnaire. It is on the reverse side of an addressed, stamped card. These cards have been made available at all Standard stations and Chevron gas stations in the Pacific West. We would greatly appreciate your obtaining one of these questionnaires at your nearest station and then taking just a moment or two to fill out the card and dropping it in the mail. We believe that it will help us bring you the music you prefer to hear on the Standard Hour. Thank you very much. We now continue with our preview of Puccini's La Boheme with Gaetano Merola, General Director of the San Francisco Opera Company, directing the San Francisco Opera Orchestra, and starring LICIA ALBANESE as Mimi, Maria Saerp as Musetta, John PEERCE as Rudolph, and Francesco Valentino as Marcel. Rudolph, the young writer, has fallen in love with the demure young girl, Mimi, who came to him for assistance after his friends Marcel, Colleen, and Shona had left their studio to prepare for a Christmas Eve feast at the Café Momousse. Rudolph brings Mimi to the feast, and there Marcel meets and is reconciled with his faithless sweetheart, Musetta. Now the Christmas season is long past. It's a dreary February morning. The snow is slowly falling. Mimi approaches the tavern from a side street, seeking Marcel, the painter. As Marcel comes out of the tavern, the bells of Saint Therese ring out their early morning call to worship. Mimi tells Marcel that Rudolph's jealousy has made her life unbearable. Marcel, trying to advise her, agrees that it would be better if she and Rudolph parted.
Thank you. vedo qui un'ora avanti l'alba, assopì sopra una panca. Salsa mi cerca. Viene.
Che non mi veda.
Torri in casate, mi per carità. Non fate scene qua.
Rudolph has come out of the tavern, and Mimi walks away to avoid meeting him. Rudolph greets Marcel and confides, I have decided to leave Mimi. I love her, but she is ill. Mimi is a flower that my poverty has wasted. To make her bloom again needs far more than my love. I fear she is dying. Rudolph hears Mimi cough and goes over to her.
Di vita di
Sadly tells Rudolph that they must part. The tender farewells are interrupted by the quarreling of Marcel and Musetta in the tavern.
Thank you.
Rudolph and Marcel are again alone in their studio. They pretend to be busy, but their thoughts are of Mimi and Musetta. Marcel takes from his pocket a bunch of ribbons Musetta has given him, and he kisses them. Rudolph flings away his pencil and picks up instead the pink bonnet that Mimi had left at the studio. Thou rose-colored bonnet, lie close against my heart, since my love has gone.
Pennello.
Schonar arrive at the studio and try to cheer Rudolph and Marcel. They pretend that the bread and fish they have brought are a sumptuous dinner. And while they are joking about it, the door bursts open and Musetta excitedly tells them that Mimi has collapsed on the stairs. Rudolph and Marcel rush out and carry her to the bed. Rudolph clasps Mimi in his arms, crying, "Mimi, darling Mimi, stay here forever with me." Later, the friends leave so that Rudolph and Mimi may be together. Mimi opens her eyes. "I pretended I was asleep," she smiles, "because I wanted to be alone with you. So many things there are that I would tell you, but one more than all the rest. You are my love, my all.
and all my life. Rudolph sobs, "You are as fair as the dawn in spring." "No," replies Mimi, her voice growing weaker. "You meant to say, fair as the flame of sunset." Her cold hands in her muff, saying, "My hands are warmer. Now I will go to sleep."
Thank you.
Musetta and the others return. Schaunard, gazing sadly at Mimi, whispers, "She's gone." A ray of sunshine lights Mimi's face, and with an anguished cry, Rudolph clasps her in his arms. "Mimi. Mimi." Puccini, the second in a series of opera programs being presented on the Standard Hour by the Standard Oil Company of California. Gaetano Merola, General Director of the San Francisco Opera Company, has conducted the San Francisco Opera Orchestra this evening, and the featured soloists were Licia Albanese as Mimi, Maria Saerz as Musetta, Jan Pierce as Rudolph, and Francesco Valentino as Marcel. The third of this series of operatic programs will be presented next week from San Francisco when Gaetano Merola, the San Francisco Opera Orchestra, and soloists Ezio Pinza, Herta Glatz, Margaret Harshaw, and Mario Berini will be heard in a condensation of Modest Mussorgsky's dramatic Russian opera, Boris Godunov. We cordially invite you to be tuned in at the regular time. The 1010th Standard Hour has been presented from the Metropolitan Theater in Seattle, Washington, and is rebroadcast by electrical transcription to the Hawaiian Islands. John Grover speaking. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.